Al Kelleher.
Hi, I'm Bob Kelleher, founder and CEO of the Employee Engagement Group, and I'd like to talk to you about the 10 steps of engagement. Step one, I believe any company looking to embark on an engagement strategy needs to link engagement to high performance.
According to a study that hasn't yet been released by Deloitte, 49% of their respondents are going to be looking for a job over the next 12 months. Today is the day that your organizations really need to focus on engagement. It is not about employee satisfaction. It's critically important that as you embark on an engagement program or culture, you link that culture with high performance.
If your leadership team is going to embark on an engagement strategy, your leadership team, specifically your CEO, has to own it. If not, employees will view it as a flavor of the month.
When there were 12 of us traveling, and the CEO, as he goes to check in, learns that he's been upgraded to a suite, and he says, I really don't want a suite. So of course I said, I'll take the suite. And he rightfully said, well, who's the lowest level person who's traveling with us? So he gave this person the suite. Okay, fast forward, she sees me in the cafeteria. She swings by and she goes, you know, why did whoever give me a suite? I said, well, Bob's the kind of CEO that he prefers to work for his employees, not the other way around. So she then tells someone, they tell someone, you can't buy that type of internal press.
Going to embark on an engagement strategy, how are you training? How are you developing? How are you establishing expectations for your first line leaders?
A well-known Gallup survey of 80,000 global employees, the number one engagement driver is your relationship with your first line supervisor. Guilty as charged, I go to supercuts. And I know some of you are saying, that explains a lot, Bob. What does supercuts have to do with leadership development? Well, I'll tell you why I go to supercuts, in addition to being cheap. Every single person that works for supercuts is trained to cut hair the same exact way. They have haircut standards. This is the baseline how we're going to cut hair. I believe organizations that want to embark on an engagement model need to have that same concept with their leadership team.
Now, your fourth step, Bob, is communication times three. So of course, if your CEO has developed this fabulous employee engagement program, but no one knows about it, how can anyone institute it? So what are some of the ways that the communication from the top down or across departments can work to institute employee engagement?
Yeah, I'm a firm believer in a firm needing to establish what I call their communication protocol. Mm-hmm. What is our communication promise to our employees? And what is the responsibility from the employees to communicate back to us? Leverage communication technology. I am old enough to remember when we didn't have school because of snow, we would hear these massive horns. Who remembers that? It's like an age question. And then, now that I'm a dad, the phone rings. Hi, this is Principal Smith at Davis Public Schools, has been called off, okay? Now my son is a student at Northeastern, he gets a text message. No school, snow. Okay, think of how technology has changed in how we communicate. Individualized engagement. I used to think there was one engagement model. Come up with an engagement program for your company. And I realized, people are motivated, engaged, very, very different. I love this quote. I grew up hearing that all the time. Although our Gen Y in Western nations, including US, are into social responsibility, changing jobs frequently. You know, my daughter once told me I'm only concerned with money. I had to tell her she's only concerned with spending my money. Well, guess what? The Gen Y kids in India and China, they have the same technological characteristics as our Gen Y, but they have the fire in the belly characteristics of us boomers as being first generation. Fast forward 10 years, 15 years, and couple that with where the engineers and scientists are coming from. If your company is not thinking global right now, you may be left behind.
Create a motivational culture. This, I believe, is the cornerstone of engagement. What are you doing to create a culture in which your employees can excel?
Early on in my career, I'm working for Metcalf and Eddie. We win the lead design engineer for the Boston Harbor Cleanup. And we couldn't find civil engineers anywhere. And I recall the CEO of our company came down into my office and said, "What the hell are you doing, Kelleher, to find us civil engineers?" And I said, "Well, the unemployment rate's 2%. Can't find any." And he said, "I don't want to hear your excuses. I want to see your results." And he stormed out of my office. And my boss comes in and goes, "He needed hope. You gave him no hope. None. He was looking for hope." Okay? And that was a very valuable leadership lesson. We had a business leader who was marginal in all of the measurements of our business. And I was doing a workshop with this business leader, and I was showing him the numbers, saying, "You're marginal in every one of your business metrics. And I'd like to present all of these metrics to your employees." And he looked at me and he said, "You call yourself Mr. Employee Engagement. Now you want to demoralize my entire team." I said, "Well, your entire team is underperforming. They're barely average. Why wouldn't you want to tell them?" And I used this term, and he got mad at me. I said, "Business isn't T-ball. It's a business. And what I've learned about employees, they may not be motivated by money, but they're incredibly motivated by achievement." So I think organizations have a responsibility to pay competitively, to reward for performance, but not look at money as an engagement driver. Worry about it as being a potential disengagement driver. I'm often asked, what comes first, engagement or profitability? And what I like to say is, you need both. And it's been my experience, if you have a profit enterprise but you lack engagement, the profitability will be short-lived. Conversely, if you have an underperforming, non-profitable business but an engaged group of employees, they will help you get out of that underperforming state quicker. It's those intangible traits that I believe define one's engagement within a firm. Mm-hmm. And companies need to know, okay, these are the traits that we value. These are the behaviors we value, which might be different than your firm. We rarely terminate someone based upon the aptitude of their ability to do the job. Mm-hmm. But it's the attitudinal things that really make a difference. Invest in engagement, but come out of the gate with a plan that can sustain the test of time, can be sustained in good times, and can be sustained in not so good times. And tell your employees it's a multiple year journey, and keep it simple and execute flawlessly.